Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It is that time of the month. It is time for monthly favorites again, and I am very excited. I have very random things for you this month. I only have a couple beauty products, and then I have a couple of other just things that I've been using all month. So we'll start with beauty, and then I'll get into the randoms. So this month has been the month of mascaras. I ran out of my Makeup Forever mascara, so I thought I should let it go and venture out and try some other ones. And this one actually is CoverGirl Clump Crusher, and I've actually been using this for a long time, but I don't use this on my top lashes, I use this on my bottom lashes. I like my top lashes to be a little bit clumpy, just a little bit, because I feel that it gives me volume. But I love this on my bottom lashes because I do not want my bottom lashes to be thick and spidery. I will save that for the top ones. And then, so for my top lashes, what I've been doing lately is I got this sample of Lancôme's Hypnose Drama Mascara, and I really like it. It's a great mascara. But I've been pairing it with this L'Oreal Voluminous Million Lashes XS. First, I'll do a coat of L'Oreal, and then I'll pull out my Lancôme one and do a coat of that. And the combo together just makes my lashes so thick looking and a little bit clumpy. So if you don't like that look, then this isn't for you. Maybe you'll just like the how this is. For lipstick this month, I have been all about this new MAC lipstick that I got about a month and a half ago. It's Hot Gossip and it's a cream sheen. It's what I'm wearing today, and I actually wore this a couple of videos ago actually when I did my foundation routine. It's a nice light pink, so it's perfect for the springtime, I think. Another product that I have rediscovered in my makeup drawer is the Makeup Forever Full Cover Concealer. It is Extreme Camouflage Cream Waterproof. It's not thick, but it gives full coverage. And what I normally do, I don't like applying this with a brush. I like warming it up in my fingers and then tapping it under my eye. I feel that it blends a lot easier that way. Speaking of under eyes, I have really, really, really sensitive under eye area for applying creams and like night creams and eye creams. I'm 32 years old and I've spent a long, long time looking for the perfect under eye cream, and I have not been able to find it. 99.9% of the products that I put on underneath my eyes burn and just feels so painful that I end up just taking it right off. Until I tried the Bobbi Brown under eye cream. This is the hydrating eye cream. And I got a sample of this from Sephora, because even though I've had trouble with under eye cream, I'm still looking for the perfect one. So I got a sample of this from Sephora. I tried it all through February pretty much and loved it. It's the only cream that I can put under my eyes and leave there, and I feel like it's hydrating and it's not burning my under eye skin. So it's expensive, but I bought the whole bottle of it. I really, really, really like it. So I'm very excited to share this with you. If you have really sensitive under eye, this is the only one that I found that works for me. Now let's talk eyebrows. I am so picky about who touches my eyebrows. There's only two people in the world that I will let touch them. Me and my threading lady. Now, unfortunately, I live in Vancouver and she lives about 45 minutes to an hour away, so I don't get to see her unless I make a trip specifically to go see her, and she's so busy that I have to book like a couple of weeks in advance. So in between when I don't get to see her, what I've been using is these little eyebrow razors. I bought this at an Asian dollar store, Daiso, here in Vancouver, and you can buy like a pack of, you can buy a pack of these and it'll be a couple of dollars, so they're really inexpensive, but I love it because it gives me the same smooth look that threading will, but my threading lady will not get mad at me because when I pluck, then she has nothing to thread. So this is perfect because it'll clean it up for whenever I need my eyebrows to be cleaned up, but then I can still get them threaded, you know, a week or so later. So I love this product for keeping my eyebrows in check. So now let's move on to non-beauty favorites. And I have really been loving, not just this month, but for a number of years, is my subscription to Lulu Magazine. This is the one that I just received a couple of days ago. I haven't had a chance to read it yet. But what I love about it is they always randomly have these coupons in there, and this month it comes with an Aldo 20% off coupon. And I mean, like, this magazine is a couple of dollars a month for a subscription. So, I mean, like, to get a 20% off Aldo coupon for a couple of dollars is an amazing deal. On top of that, they have great articles. It's a Canadian magazine and it talks about fashion and makeup and everything that I love. So I wanted to share it with you. All right, so on to my last favorite. I have a confession. I hate drinking water and it is something that I've struggled with for a long time. I love Diet Pepsi. That has always been my number one favorite drink. But I have been trying to get healthier in the last couple of months, and in order to do so, I have cut Pepsi out of my life. Unfortunately, it's been difficult. But one thing that has helped me up my water intake are these cups. And I got this, it comes in a pack of three at Costco, and it comes with multicolored straws. So what I normally do is just fill this up first thing in the morning and sip on it as I'm doing my makeup, getting ready in the morning, and then I just continually refill it. By the end of the day, I've somehow managed to go through like four or five of these glasses, and without even thinking, you don't have to get the ones from Costco, you can find these anywhere. I think like Winners and HomeSense, and they all have these kind of cups and stuff lying around. So that is my monthly favorites for this month. There wasn't a ton of stuff. I've just been super excited for it to finally start getting warmer here in Vancouver so I can put away my winter stuff and bring out all my spring nice colorful things. Anyways, thank you so much for watching and I will see you soon. Bye!